Hello, my name is Christian Heiduschke. I'm team manager at IUE, and I would like to show you how CarMaker helps us to enable virtual validation for automated driving function with multi-sensor simulation in closed-loop environments.
At first, I would like to start with a short introduction to Project HEAT. HEAT stands for Hamburg Electric Autonomous Transportation, and the goal is to develop a shuttle for public transport. Initially, some general project characteristics. HEAT is set up as a research project together with Hamburg Hochbahn, City of Hamburg, Siemens, HI Solutions, ICEM, DLR, and supported by the German Federal Ministry for the Environment, Nature Conservation and Nuclear Safety. IUE is responsible for the vehicle, including the autonomous driving functions, and the project duration is from 2018 until 2021. What are the key objectives? Number one is safety and technology. Can driverless vehicles or minibuses be used for regular operations in public transport? Is the needed technology available? This shall be investigated under following boundary conditions: a maximum speed of 50 kilometers per hour, regular road traffic, and without stewards on board. The second is customer acceptance. How do our customers react to the new technology? How does the vehicle interact with other traffic participants? And last, new business models. How do profitable and sustainable business models for autonomous vehicles look like? How can these models be integrated with the current public transport systems? How is our technical approach for ID? It seeks Trinity. This means we have a three-layer approach. Layer one are the technical components for autonomous driving. They are on board of the shuttle. Second are the decentral infrastructure centers and digital communication systems on the road. And the third layer is the control center. The shuttle will be supervised permanently by Hochbahn. The project goal is the showcase operation at ITS World Congress 2021 in Hamburg. There will be a 2-kilometer route on public roads in the hafen city with fixed bus stops, and the shuttle should transport ITS guests. On this slide, you can see a development overview of the IUE tasks. IUE is developing solutions for HEAT in the area of app development, chassis development, UX and infotainment, connectivity, e-mobility, and cross-automated driving. For this, there are several disciplines. Next to the development of concepts, perception, planning, acting, and safety layer, there's also validation and the related topics. This area will be the main part of this presentation. So, what is the strategy to ensure safe and comfortable operation and to get the admission to drive without a human driver in the area of Hafen City? We decided to have a double test approach: scenario-based and endurance tests in parallel. For validation and verification activities, we have set up several virtual test environments on different test levels. Started with concept-in-the-loop approaches for early validation on the left side of the Wii model, over ZIL environments with 2D simulations, up to high complex 3D system hill environments. Additional to this, there are real test shuttles for validation and certification right in the Hafen City. Because of the large parameter space for variation, there's an enormous test scope. To be able to handle this scope, we implemented our algorithm for parameter space analysis called IUE Compass. This allows us to maximize the test effort on high scalable test levels like soft render loop, and minimize the effort on complex levels like the vehicle test. The endurance run takes part at virtual test levels with 3D simulation and in the test vehicle. RPG CarMaker is used in 3D hill environments for scenario-based test activities and endurance runs as well. The next slide shows the sensor setup of Heat, which has been the base for modeling the virtual environment. All in all, there are 3 zones of sensing. The vehicle zone, which has all sensors on board which are necessary for a redundant all-round view as input for automated driving functions. The second zone is V2X, which allows communication with control center, traffic lights, and so on. And the third is the infrastructure zone, which gives us information about non-visible areas of the track. For the simulation environment, vehicle zone is the most interesting. The shuttle is equipped with a comprehensive set of sensors, which consists of 4 area view cameras, one on each side. In the front, a high resolution camera with integrated image processing. All around the vehicle, 5 radar sensors and additional 8 360 degree 16 channel LiDAR, and on the top of the vehicle a 360 degree 40 channel LiDAR. This 3 zone setup gives us an additional safety layer and allows higher speeds without loss of safety. Nevertheless, all sensors that are necessary for safe operation are on board. That's why we focused at the beginning to the modeling of the vehicle zone. The realization in CarMaker is described on the next slide. Starting from the sensor setup of Heat, we derived from the architecture of the autonomous driving system which level of sensor modeling will be necessary in the simulation environment. Since the whole intelligence for interpretation, fusion, and planning is part of the AD system, it became clear that we need sensor models on the physical level. This means all LiDAR and radar, as well as 4 or 5 camera sensors, are sending raw data to the central computing units. As a result, we defined 2 very general requirements. First, we want to set up physical sensor models for radar, camera, and LiDAR in a simulation environment. And second, we want to compute the raw data in parallel and nearly in real time. Because of the complexity to simulate the huge amount of 19 sensors, we started with the evaluation of simulation environments. After we decided to rely on IPG CarMaker, we started to model the sensors. Our approach was to use the partially new raw signal interfaces, and so we got the following setup. 1 LiDAR RSI with 40 discontinuous channels, 8 LiDAR RSI with 16 continuous channels, 5 radar RSI, 4 camera RSI, and at last, 1 camera hi-fi sensor, because 1 camera is sending object lists. Top right is a short demo video of the simulated LiDAR point cloud in CarMaker. Directly below, the visualization of this data by the AD system. When we finished modeling the sensors, the next challenge arose. What setup is necessary to parallelize the simulation for real-time computation of the data? This brings me to the next step. Which hardware setup and configuration is needed for that? The requirements to our hardware in the loop setup were quite clear. We needed sufficient CPU and GPU performance for parallel computation of the sensor data. Secondly, it should be possible in real time to enable closed loop tests. And last, the setup should be affordable as a base for scaling up the test resources. So we started together with IPG a detailed investigation of potential hardware setups. Therefore, we tested over 10 configurations with regard to our requirements. The result of this investigation was one base for our approach. We decided to have a Windows-based system with a high-performance Intel CPU. For parallelization of the computation effort, we are using 4 high-performance NVIDIA GPU and developed a smart distribution of the processes to get the best result out of the number of parallel entities and the distribution effort. CarMaker is set up as co-simulation with Vector Canoe for simulation of the bus communication, and the whole system is fully automated by Tristronic ECU test. This allows us to integrate single test benches to our overall test automation toolchain, including a smart test load balancing, a health monitoring, the access to the parameter space algorithm, and a central database for all test results. After the general simulation was set up, we put our focus on the generation of the digital road network. According to the validation strategy, we identified 2 requirements. They have to be generic roads on the one side, which gives us the possibility to adapt the road network in an easy way. And on the other side, there should be a high precise road network of the actual track in Hamburg Hafen City. So we created generic roads for scenario-based validation and verification activities. An example, therefore, shown top right for a straight road. This example can be modified by automation, which gives us the opportunity to look at large parameter spaces without high effort for scenario modeling. Secondly, and mainly for endurance test activities, we created high precision CarMaker road network from generated HD maps, which were provided as OpenDrive. This road is shown bottom right. There we have a highly accurate and detailed model with regard to relevant zones of the traffic area. Let's have an insight into real heat test activities. On the left, you can see the heat shuttle in the complex model of Hafen City road network running on a hardware in the loop test bench. The shown scenario describes a part of the 2020 test track with a turning maneuver at the beginning, a short stop at the bus station shown there, and 2 further turning maneuvers. At the right, there's a short clip from real-world test with the heat shuttle in Hamburg. As you can see in this phase, there was an engineer on board who observed the correct operation. This was caused by safety regulations for this project phase. To sum up, with the help of IPG CarMaker, we achieved some important milestones for the research project HEAT. We built up a simulation environment for the virtual validation of the whole AD system with a massive parallelization of sensor simulation on a physical level. Furthermore, we designed a highly adaptable test environment that allows us, via a generic connection between simulation and system under test, a fast adaptation to other projects. In addition, this all is possible with an affordable hardware and software setup. What are the next steps? Extending the sensor simulation by models for V2X and LiDAR radar infrastructure sensors to increase the detail level of our virtual test environments. Step number one. Step number two is the automated creation of HD road networks from commercial databases. And third step, an implementation of smart microscopic traffic simulation for all traffic participants to improve the significance of virtual endurance runs. Altogether, the simulation environment for virtual validation with CarMaker helps us to push forward the development of autonomous driving functions for HEAT and for our customers. This brings me to the end of this presentation. Thank you for watching, and do not hesitate to contact me with further questions.